Welcome to the screencast about keyboard templates in PHPEdit. Keyboard templates can help you to be more efficient while you create your code. One of the most easiest examples is a class template. It will create a complete class definition based on your clipboard content. Just type class, followed by a space, and PHPEdit will expand the code template for you. Another example is the for each loop. As you can see, keyboard templates are also available in Code Insight. Just pick the for each template from the list and press return. PHPEdit will expand the template for you. The result is a complete for each loop where you just need to fill the blanks. To display you another feature, let's delete the created code. You can modify the templates inside the settings. Open the language section and choose a language for which you would like to change a template. We've chosen PHP in our example. Open the category for your template, select the item and choose Edit, or open it with a double click. We can now modify the content to have it more optimized for our usage. I would like to have my name added to each new class, and I would like to use the constructor from PHP 5. When we close the settings now and use the shortcut again, our new content will be used. Keyboard templates are different for each language. When we create a new XSLT file and use the XSL template shortcut, we get a complete template match inside our code. You can access the different languages from the settings with the subkey keyboard templates. They are all grouped by category and can be modified to everything you would like to use. PHPEdit allows you to create new templates. Just choose the language inside which you would like to use it, choose a category, and press a button for new template. Enter a shortcut with which you will access it later, and press the edit button to change the content. I create a comment which defines a copyright statement for waterproof. I enter a description for it, and the content that should be expanded into the code. The last step is to choose where it should be available. I select that it should only be expanded in commands inside PHP code. Now it can be used inside each command, and I can be sure that I use the right one and do not have any misspellings inside it. There is a keyboard template for to-do items defined for PHP code. We can use it, and it will add the current class and method to the to-do item as its category. When we open it inside the settings, we see a special macro which is executed before the template is expanded. Every possible macro is available from the menu on the top right. We will add the one for the current user to the template. The parameter u can be used to assign a user to an item. Also, we add a special marks for creating a selection before and right after the new parameter. We remove the special marker for the caret and instead define a quick mark to which we can jump easily. When we expand the to-do item now, the user is added and selected. When we do not want to change it, we directly jump to the quick mark. When we now try to execute the to-do shortcut in normal PHP code, it will not be expanded. We can go to the settings and change that behavior. When it's executed now, it will be used. We just need to be sure to add the comment signs in front of it, otherwise our PHP code wouldn't be valid. Thank you for taking your time to view this screencast. If you need assistance or you would like to view more related screencasts, please visit one of the following links.